Alright, so here's this Acer laptop. So somebody gave me this laptop because it had some kind of problem and they took the hard drive out and the guy never returned it to them, so I don't have the hard drive, so I just have the laptop. But what I have it connected up to this USB drive, which was actually a CD drive, but I connected up to the up to a hard drive instead. And it gets to this screen, it recognizes that there must be Windows on the hard drive, and I have three different hard drives that I've tried with this, and all of them do the exact same thing. So when I press enter there, it's good. Okay, there we go. And then it flashes a blue screen real quick with some words, I can't tell what it says, and that's it. It does. So it could be a problem with the laptop, because I've tried three different hard drives and all of them do the same thing. It could be this, this little board here, I don't know. So I'm gonna trash it, so. Yeah. So a few people were wondering about keyboards in my other laptop fix video. So if you lose a few keys, they're usually pretty easy to replace. You can often, on like eBay or something, you can find a key that you just stick on. As long as this hardware right here is not missing, you can just put a new key back on there. Or you can pop the bezel off, which is usually right here. This one's a little weird, probably because it's a cheap laptop. And they make it harder to replace the keyboard, so you just have to buy a new one. But usually this pops off right here. This one seems to be a little tough, but usually that pops off. There's two or three screws under there. You pop it off, and there's a ribbon cable that pops out. I'm also going to ruin the touchpad here. So let's say your kid is playing Minecraft. Oh no, there's another creeper! So I'm going to see if I can fix that. That doesn't seem very fixable, but I don't know. Might be able to fix that. Kind of sounds like I ruined the button. Well, we'll see what it looks like inside. So, somebody was playing Minecraft too viciously on here. They got a little bit too carried away and they broke the button. We'll see if we can fix that or not, but it's pretty broken there. It actually was pretty easy. I didn't have to push that hard, but so yeah, we'll tear it down. I think it's I'm not exactly sure the year on this, but yeah, let's tear it down. So, alright, so let's tear this thing apart. So, take out the battery first. And I'm going to be using this little drill here that I made. This is actually from a Roomba. This is one of the drive motors from a Roomba robot. But it's just hooked up to a power supply. I think it's like 24 volts or something, but it works okay. It doesn't have a lot of torque, but it gets the job done. I usually have to loosen the screws first. Alright, so let's pop the covers off. So, covers, not too much interesting about them. So, we've got the fan here. I don't really like how the heatsink is on here. It's not held on the, this is probably the, well, there's the main processor, and then this is probably the graphics card, or graphics processor. it's not held on there. It's just kind of, yeah, not very good design there. Pop the RAM out here. And pop it. Well, I suppose I should see how hard it is to replace the, or fix the touchpad. Now that I broke that, let's see if there's any more screws in here. It looks like a fan has to come out. There's the fan. Those are pretty nice little fans, the centrifugal ones. Let's see. There's some more screws. There's the wireless card and the antennas. I think that might be all of the screws. We're probably going to run into more. Here's another one. And that one's not. Let's see if it'll come apart now. I don't know. Seems a little tough. There we go. I wonder if this might have to come off first. I mean, it doesn't really look like it's supposed to come off. It looks quite attached. Maybe it is supposed to come off. Oh, there we are. So that bezel comes off there. And then we can get these screws here. So this is how you replace the keyboard. There's the keyboard, and there might be some more screws in here. Yes, it does look like these might have to come out here. So all these screws won't come out here. I don't know why. It's like they're connected to something. I don't know why they're not coming out. That's kind of odd. Being really bad. Well, there's one of them. The other one still won't come out, though. Alright, I'm doing the last resort here. Just gonna cut the head off of this stupid screw. It just won't come out of here. I don't know why. Yeah, it's like really stuck in there. Like really stuck. There we go. Broke it off. Okay, here we go. Now we've got it all coming apart here. So, unplug that. Yeah, this thing's not going to work again. So, that's probably the antenna. No, that's probably the high voltage for the bulb. Now we got to take these out. Alright, that should be all the screws here, so this should come off now. There we go. Now, what was causing our problem? Oh, there we go. Okay, so we pulled the part that's in the plastic out when I was wrenching on it to try and get it apart. And that's what's stopping us from pulling that screw out. Stupid screw. Okay, so... So let's see here, so we've got some tape there for some, that just holds down that wire. Kind of cheap tape to have in a laptop, but it's just normal tape. Unless it was taken apart and put back together at one time. Here's the speakers. They're screwed in. Oh, so yeah, the touchpad, let's see what we ruined here. Where this wire goes here. Yeah, that's the wireless. Alright, so here's the heatsink. It's got some dust in it, not bad. It's got a good amount of paste on there. Yeah, but I still don't like how it's just kind of sitting on there. Is separated. It's pretty light. So, let's look at that touchpad that we ruined here. Pull this plastic off. Oh, gotta watch the little ribbon cables. Didn't break it, but... So we popped the plastic, little plastic melted parts off, just like on my laptop. So, you just need to glue that back on, and it would probably work again. Maybe. Yeah, it would work again. If you just glued that right there, those two little plastic bits that were melted and popped off, it would probably work. So. I keep missing the screws here. So here's the touchpad. Wait a minute. Oh, you know what? The buttons must be on the... Yeah, the buttons are on the motherboard, actually. Not on the... So this is just the touchpad module here. So... I don't know if you could actually use the touchpad module for anything, but... I don't know. So, keep that. That's about everything off of here, though. Off this part. Nothing at all more on here. Just metal shielding. That's about it. It's just a piece of flimsy plastic. So, chuck that. Alright, so we've got the main board here. Take this apart. So we've got, this looks like the yeah, I think this is the see here. Yeah, high voltage. So this is the driver for the fluorescent tubes, or fluorescent tube. So let's get the main board off here. Find some screws on here to get rid of. I'm not seeing too many screws here. Now here's the USB ports and some other buttons and lights. And here's some. So there's the main board. We'll pop the CPU out and see what it looks like. It's just gonna be a normal CPU though. Here is it. I don't think it has a year on here. No date, so. So, yeah. Well, you know what? I bet I could plug a drive in there, a solder drive. Yeah, that's the same exact ports. Huh. I didn't know that the mini ones use the same ports. It looks the same. Same distance, I think. Well, I'll have to try that. It'd probably still work as is right now. You might have to put the CPU and everything back together, but it'd probably still work, I would imagine. If I haven't ruined anything yet. I'd actually be surprised if I didn't. Even though I've been pretty rough to it, but... yeah, old. That's just a phone jack cable. Phone jack there. So, all there's left in here is the speakers. That was the microphone, I think. Alright, so here's the speakers. And that's it. So, oh, there are little tiny speakers there. Yeah, that's it. So, just plastic. Alright, so, now we've got the screen. There's the backup battery, too. So, yeah, I'll probably keep this. I don't know if I'll want that. Might need it for something. I don't know. So, it looks like this is probably high voltage for the lamp. And then here we've got the video input. So, this has a webcam, too. So this probably has webcam wires here too, I would imagine. So let's pop these little rubber thingies off here, off the corners. Alright, here we've got the screen. You know what, that probably wasn't the, that little board wasn't the high voltage driver, that was something else, probably. I don't know what that is, though. Because this looks like the high voltage driver right here. It's got a little cable that goes back up in the back there. That plugged into that, so I don't know what that was. Oh, wait, do I even need to... I don't need to take those out, just these down here. Alright, so the screen should come out now. Turn these up. There we go. And there we've got the screen. Oh, okay, so these two wires here go to the webcam. Or this little wire goes up to the webcam then. So here's the webcam. Pop that out. Even inside of a sheath for some reason. Protect it from something. There's three. Yeah, there's three wires that. No, maybe four. Four wires that go to it. But I don't know if I might be able to use that for something or not. Okay, so here's the high voltage driver there for the main board. Or for the CFL. So. We'll tear it down so we can get the bulb out, because I want the bulb for my Tesla coil, so I'm going to be using that. That's an odd antenna. Huh. The antennas just go up to the corners here with this metal, and then there's a piece of, looks like copper on the back here. Huh. I don't know what those, why it's like that. It's kind of weird antenna. Alright, so let's get this apart so we can get the bulb out. So, let's see how we do this. Looks like these screws here come out. Oops, just broke the bulb. Too bad. Too late now. Guess that's part you have to be kind of careful about, which I wasn't too careful about, so it's broken now. Here we've got the diffuser plastic. It's got little weird bumps on it. And we've got more plastic diffusers and more and more. And the LCD. So, oh, not too much there. Too bad it broke the ball. That's okay. Really fragile, that's for sure. This one's probably the thinnest one I've seen. It's only, oh, probably like 2 millimeters in diameter. It's really small. Huh. But yeah, so that's the laptop all taken apart. So, yeah. So that's the last thing.